So now, having talked about the fetal circulation, how blood flows through the fetus, we are now going to talk about some of the things that happens. In fact, the changes that will happen when the umbilical cord is cut. Of course, everyone when they are in the uterus, they depend on their mother. They depend on their mother for everything. But once the umbilical cord is cut, then all is done. And then the baby has to be independent. And it is said, according to research, that this is the most difficult adaptation that the baby undergoes through their life. So what are some of the changes that take place? Well, we are going to understand this if we understand how blood flows, and if we understand the fetal circulation, and if we understand some of the systems, how they work in the baby once they are in the uterus, because it is only these systems that are going to be affected. For example, cutting of the umbilical cord. When we cut the umbilical cord after birth, there is going to be disruption, the disruption of blood supply from the placenta to this gut. Because the umbilical cord via the umbilical vein was supplying the baby with the blood, the oxygen, and all the nutrients that were needed for the baby to survive. But in this case, where the umbilical cord is cut, that means the umbilical vein is also cut, and that means the baby's lungs are supposed to start adapting to new changes. And this marks the start of the baby. And this can only happen during the first breath. So when the baby is born, when they breathe for the first time, once this is cut, when they breathe for the first time, then their fluids are going to be excreted from the lungs. And then even when during the time the baby is passing through the birth canal, then the baby's chest is going to be compressed such that the fluids which were occupying the lungs, some of it will be excreted via the mouth or via the nose. They are going to be expelled, and that marks the start of the working of the lungs. That's why it's important that the child at birth cries, because once they cry, they are going to release those fluids from the lungs to be excreted via the mouth. So it is very important. So one of the adaptations that happens is that this thing is going to close, and then it's going to come the part of the supporting ligaments of the liver, the umbilical vein. And the other thing is the ductus venosus closes shortly, within 2 days. It's not going to exceed 2 days. It's supposed to short, to close. And then this can go on to become the ductus venosum. It's going to come the ductus venosum. The other physiological change that happens is that the foramen ovale. I want to dwell a bit on foramen ovalis closure, because what it is that this is the wall, the window between the two septa, between the two arteries, atrium, and that is the left atrium and the right atrium. So there are going to be a window like this, which opens through in the or towards the left side of the heart, that is the left atrium. And when blood comes like this, when blood comes from this side, it will open over that side, and then the blood will go in this side. But when the lungs start working, it's going to be pressure in the lungs is going to be reduced, and that will cause the blood which is in the to start circulating in the lungs, because the lungs has been now released, there is no more fluid, so the blood will start circulating. And once the blood starts circulating, that simply means that 2 to 4 veins, the pulmonary veins which are carrying blood from the lungs towards the heart are going to start working now. And then the blood will start flowing through these pulmonary veins. And when these pulmonary veins start getting blood into this side, then that simply means the blood is going to be high in this side. And in the left atrium, when there is high amount of blood, then that will cause this foramen ovale to flap in like this. Blood is coming from this side, and then it will flap this, and then it will close also. So this is very important to know, the anatomy. It takes to about 8 to 10 days, but immediately after birth, it's going to close temporarily, and then in about before the end of 12 days, it's going to close completely. And if it doesn't close, then it's abnormal. The other thing is that the ductus arteriosus also is going to close, because there is no more pressure coming back from the lungs. The lungs are now working, so there will not be any pressure. Pressure from the lungs, which was as a result of the lungs being fluid, being filled with a lot of fluids, is no more, because the baby has cried. Because during birth, the baby has been compressed, the chest of the baby has been compressed, and therefore the baby has excreted some of the fluids from the lungs, and that simply means there will be no pressure in the pulmonary arteries. And that simply means because the pulmonary veins have started working, taking blood in the left atrium, and this one will also close. And this one also changes its name from ductus arteriosus. It goes on to become the ligamentum arteriosum. That's its adaptation. It's going to change also. It's going to come to become the ligamentum arteriosum. Those are some of the structures are going to become some of the part of the supporting ligaments of the body. And those are some of the changes that happen during the fetal life. Because of course, even the two umbilical arteries are going to be cut. They are also going to become part of the supporting ligaments of the body. And this is simply what happens. The least I would like to talk about is suggesting some of the importance of delaying cutting of the umbilical cord. Because according to the WHO, the World Health Organization suggests that a delay of at least 1 minute in cutting the umbilical cord is advised. And I want to talk about this. This is very important clinically, because as we delay, there's going to be a few amount of blood which was retained in the placenta. But before we cut if we rush to cut the umbilical cord, then that simply means that blood will not go back to the fetus, and the baby will be at risk of anemia. So it is very important that we delay at least 1 minute in order to allow the blood which was in the placenta to go back in the fetal life, in the fetal circulation. And that simply means we are doing a very great job. We are going to protect this baby at least from the risk of developing anemia or developing future complications such as respiratory distress syndrome as a result of lack of oxygen which was in the blood, which was already manufactured by the mother. So it is very important that we understand this. Thank you so much. God bless you.